I had ancestors in America during the Revolution. They were Moravians, and therefore pacifists who refused to fight. You may disagree with that, but it was their firm biblical conviction. They were sentenced to hard labor for daring to take no stance on the issues of the day. The minute things get serious, the knives come out and their countenance towards us changes. Christians were tolerated in Rome until they refused to burn incense to Caesar. Then they were thrown to the wild beasts in the arena. This is because the world does not acknowledge the existence of the kingdom of God. We are operating on two different planes, and the world cannot abide that. We may take the issues just as seriously as they do, but since they do not acknowledge the possibility of a spiritual solution, they demand that we act as if we believed the same as they do. Whether they view us as a threat, or an insult, or an inconvenience, the world has declared our faith to be aberrant. For those who do not agree, there is immense societal pressure to bend the knee. How does this pressure come? The book of Nehemiah gives us a masterclass on pressure from the world. As Nehemiah led the people to build the walls of Jerusalem, the nations around them tried everything to stop them from succeeding. The devil only has a few tricks, but they are deadly. Pressure comes through mockery, like the regional rulers who mocked Nehemiah's work on the wall. "A fox could knock it down," they cried. I am sure every one of you has been mocked for your faith. When the fellas at work are heading out to the strip club and you say no thank you, there are all kinds of blasphemies hurled your way. It comes through shame, like the tweets and op-eds you see published today. The princes surrounding Nehemiah tried to cajole him into letting them join, calling his integrity into question. Shame can be a powerful tool, especially for young people, and there is no shortage of media pundits and college professors willing to browbeat Christians into submission. It comes through ostracization, when Christians are not permitted to participate in society because of their faith. Nehemiah's opponents wrote letters to the emperor to have him recalled or at least forced to stop construction on the wall. Christians today, for example, may not hold public office in many Islamic and atheist countries around the world. How long until Christianity itself becomes ground for being canceled? It comes through outright violence. Nehemiah's rivals tried to lure him to a peace conference where they had set a trap to kill him. In Japan, during the Shimabara Rebellion in 1638, Christians were crucified on crosses out past the tide line. They were drowned in agony as the waves came in. Throughout history, the Christian has spent as much time in the dungeon and gulag as he has in the seminary or the sanctuary. And lastly, this pressure can come in the form of infiltration. Nehemiah went home for a time, and when he returned to Jerusalem, Tobiah, one of his most cunning adversaries, had a guest room in the temple. If we cannot be stopped, the world will try to send activists and false teachers into the church who care nothing about the message of the gospel, but only want to further their own agenda through denominational institutions. This is more prevalent than I think many of us would care to admit. We have been blessed for centuries to live in a nation that permits freedom of worship. But now that the pressure seems to be increasing, we must not panic. Peter said not to be surprised at the fiery trial when it comes upon you to test you, as though something strange were happening to you. 1 Peter 4:12. That famous verse was not in reference to executions, but to insults. This is the lot of the Christian. We are pilgrims in this world, citizens of a different kingdom. Jesus said, "It is enough for the disciple to be like his teacher and the servant like his master." If they have called the master of the house Beelzebul, how much more will they malign those of his household? Matthew 10:25. Jesus faced pressure to conform, and you as his disciple should expect no different.